pretty much, I would say, a morning person. And I like to just make sure that my day is planned in advance. I have several calendars electronically and hard copy, just to-do lists that I just go through and make sure I click off or check off just to make sure that my days are being productive. So with that, I get up a little, you know, earlier than most just to make sure that I have everything, my ducks in a row, all planned out, any emails that I need to send out, communication that needs to go out. I'm already on top of that from the pretty much early in the morning. And, you know, I stay in the bed, I kind of go through it in my mind, put out my phone, make sure that everything is ready to go. And then yesterday morning, you know, something just interrupted my day right in the middle of just me thinking of checklists and tasks and to-do lists and all of that. I heard the voice of the Lord say to me, Nadine, the first thing that you're supposed to do, that you ought to do when you wake up in the morning, is to get on your knees. I mean, it was just so clear, not a rebuke, but a loving nudge. The first thing you do, Nadine, is to acknowledge me. Put me first, even before you start your day, right? And so I heeded that voice, got up, got on my knees. And the first thing I began to do was just to worship the Lord and ask for forgiveness, right? Because I realized that, you know, everything else was coming before him. All my productivity list and checklist and task list and all of that stuff that to make sure that my day goes well and excellent. But regardless, I was doing it without him. And as I was on my knees, I just began to worship and I just acknowledge and honor and just enter into his presence and have him overwhelm my space, my environment, all of that stuff, which, you know, always bring a calm and a sense of peace and a gathering of thoughts and a clear mindset. All of that began to just kind of come into alignment for me. So I had to worship him. The second thing that I did was acknowledge him, acknowledge his presence, acknowledge his correction, acknowledge who he is in my life. And then thirdly, what I had to do was send him ahead of my day. Send him, ask him to go before my day, whatever meetings I had, whatever appointments that I had to make, or whatever I had tasks that I had to put my hands to, that God will go before me and set up my day for me, that he will be ahead of it, not only with me, but ahead of me. And then fourthly, I just had to acknowledge and give him permission. Let's scratch the word acknowledge, but give God permission to interrupt my plans. You know that a man orders or plans his way, but God is the one who establishes his steps. And so I had to give God permission, establish my step. I know I have the plans, Lord, whether it's in my day, on my agenda, on my calendar, but even concerning my life, I know I have my plans, Lord, but would you establish my way? I know I have my checklist and all that kind of stuff, but Lord, I want to acknowledge you in everything that I do. You know, Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 says that in all our ways, trust in the Lord in all our ways. I mean, trust in the Lord with all our heart, but in all our ways, acknowledge him and he will direct our path. Acknowledge him in the tasks that you're doing. Acknowledge him in the meetings and the appointments that you have. Just acknowledge, okay, God, I need your mind. I need the mind of Christ. I need clarity. I need creativity. I need to make sure that my words are being spoken in a way that is edifying, respectful, and honoring with wisdom, right? And knowledge and insight, all of those things. You're acknowledging the Lord, and he will direct your steps. You know, before you go, I want to leave you. David was a man. We know David in the Bible. King David was a man of valor and strength. He was a man of war and strategy. He defeated armies upon armies. I mean, he had a track record of victory. Not only was God's favor on his life and God was with him, we know that, but there's a reason for that. Yes, he was a man after God's own heart, but there's a reason for that. And 1 Samuel 23, 1 Samuel 30, 2 Samuel 2, 2 Samuel 5, 2 Samuel 21, all of those passages and then some, in even though David had strategy of war to be combative and victorious in battle. Even though he had that, all of those texts that I just mentioned to you, David inquired of the Lord. And here's what he said, "Lord, shall I go up?" This was a man who knew battle strategy. He had seen victories. He knew how what it was to ambush and what it was to defeat armies, even if he was outnumbered. And yet, through it all, doesn't matter, he still inquired of the Lord, because he knew, God, if you're not with me, if you don't go before me, then I've already lost this battle. Matter of fact, there was a battle that he had just came from and he won. And there was another battle that was before him that looked just like the one he just won. And even then, David said to the Lord, "Lord, are you with me? Shall I go up?" It looks like the same plan. It looks like it will be the same strategy, but I need to know that you are with me on this, that you've gone ahead of me on this. And here's what the Lord said to David. Don't. Hold your ground. Hold fast. I'm going to do it a different way. Listen, that's why it's important to send God ahead of you, knowing that God is with you, but also giving God permission to interrupt your plans. Why? His plans and his ways are better than our plans and our ways. He has an advantageous view. He sees what's up ahead and around the corner. All you're seeing is a few steps in front of you. God sees it. He has the bird's eye view. He's 30,000 feet. He has the airplane view to your situation. And so you want, his ways are higher than your ways and my ways. His thoughts are higher than our thoughts. So you want God to go ahead of you. You want God's plans. You want God's strategy, because his plans and his strategy will always come out on the other side victoriously. And so I just want to encourage you with that this week, to put God first. He wants first position. When you get up in the morning, acknowledge him, ask him to go before you, give him permission to interrupt your plans. You know, sometimes those plans, when he interrupts them, it's a divine intervention. He does things he orchestrates things that you could have never thought of on your own. And looking back, you're like, wow, God, that was all you. That was all. I'm so glad that you usurped or you overthrew my plans, because your plans were so much better. So if we encourage this week, put God first, acknowledge him in all your ways, and he will direct your path. Lord, I just want to thank you for the person that's on the other end of the screen. I pray that you will establish them in all their ways. I pray that whatever they put their hands to, Lord, as long as they're acknowledging you in it and bringing you to asking you to go before it and giving you their plans, giving you permission to interrupt their plans with your own, Lord, I pray that you would grant them success on every side. I pray that you would grant them victories in every battle. Lord God, not only go before them, but walk with them and also be their rear guard as well. Well, as the scripture says, Lord, surround them with your mercy, but also surround them with your favor. I thank you for them, and I ask that you would bless their lives and then cause them to be a blessing to the lives of others. God bless you. Talk to you soon.